afternoon, and we're thankful that we have the Lord Jesus Christ who has an elder brother and has also a high priest that can remove all sin and all shame. I farm in Madison County with my wife, Cinda, and I'm going to take an example from everyday life that I want to share with you this afternoon. It comes from Galatians 3, verse 15. Brothers, let me take an example from everyday life. Just as no one can set aside or add to the human covenant that has been duly established, so it is in this case. The promises were spoken to Abraham and to his seed. The scripture does not say, and to seeds, meaning many people, but, and to your seed, meaning one person who is Christ. What I mean is this. The law introduced 430 years later does not set aside the covenant previously established by God and thus do away with the promise. For if the inheritance depends on the law, then it no longer depends on a promise. But God in his grace gave it to Abraham through a promise. Let's keep turning over to Romans chapter 7, verse 5. For when we were controlled by the sinful nature, the sinful passions aroused by the law were at work in our bodies, so that we bore fruit for death. But now, by dying to what once bound us, we have been released from the law, so that we serve in the new way of the Spirit, and not in the old way of the written code. And I'm thankful for this morning and this afternoon, wherever the word is being preached. We're happy to have that forgiveness of sins by the Spirit. For the Spirit can't enter in if there's not forgiveness of sins. Thus, as we meet our Lord in baptism and are clothed with Christ, it's not only a one-point action, it's a continual action. We have to clothe ourselves with Christ daily and put the flesh down. We turn to Romans 6:6. We know that our old self was crucified with him, but the body of sin might be rendered powerless, that we should no longer be slaves to sin, because anyone who has died has been freed from sin. In Romans 6:16, don't you know that when you offer yourselves to someone to obey them as slaves, you are slaves to the one whom you obey, whether you are slaves to sin, which leads to death, or to obedience, which leads to righteousness. And 17, but thanks be to God that though you used to be slaves to sin, you wholeheartedly obeyed the form of teaching to which you were entrusted. You have been set free from sin and become slaves to righteousness. Turn over to 8:12. Therefore, brothers, we have an obligation, but it is not according to the sinful nature to live according to it. For if you live according to the sinful nature, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body. Hebrews 10. My last thought I want to share with you on the Lord's Word. Hebrews 10.
Hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful.
together, as some are in the habit of doing. But let us encourage one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. I hope that through our fellowship and through the preaching of God's word, that we can spur one another through this time period, and as we share with one another, may we also give